15 months and counting into the COVID-19 pandemic, the world faces a difficult reality, an unprecedented education crisis. More than half of all students worldwide have been affected by school closures, putting their learning and development at risk, denying them contact with their peers and trained, caring teachers, making them miss out on essential health care, nutrition, and protection services, and affecting their mental health and well-being. A recent UNICEF survey across 77 countries found that children and adolescents are reporting dramatic increases in stress, anxiety, irritability, and substance abuse. The longer children are out of school, the worse the mental health impacts. Impacts that make them vulnerable to abuse and exploitation. Impacts that can last a lifetime, especially for those children who are already disadvantaged by poverty or children with different abilities. Because they are migrants or refugees, or because they are living in humanitarian emergencies like conflicts or disasters. While COVID-19 has closed schools, it has also decimated support services like mental health services and school counseling, leaving millions of children and their families without this critical support when they need it most. As countries prepare to reopen schools, UNICEF believes that this is also a moment to strengthen mental health support across education systems, which is why we have joined the World Bank and UNESCO to launch our joint mission to recover education. First, by sparing no effort to keep schools open and ensure that every student returns. When they do return to in-person learning, we urge governments to ensure that children have access to the health and protection services that they need, including for mental health, and including nutritious meals and safe spaces where they can share their experiences and worries with trained teachers and also mental health experts. In any pandemic scenario, schools should be the last to close and the first to reopen. And second, we need to support children as they catch up on missed learning. This is urgent. They must not fall further behind. And third, we need to invest in teachers, including through trained focused on meeting the learning and the mental health needs of their students. UNICEF sees this as a critical moment to reimagine education and mental health systems in the years ahead, to help the world's youngest generation through and beyond what has been a devastating moment for them. As a global community, let us rally around their needs and let us make sure that they return to schools where they can get their learning and the mental health back on track.